Hi, this is Caitlin from KMK Designs. This is a short tutorial of how to make the doublet velvet trim for Assassin's Creed Ezio cosplay, which I did recently. This is a photo of the finished work. Centerpiece is from Fev Studios. I'll include a link below so you guys can see where to get that. And the rest was done by KMK Designs for one of our awesome clients. I'm hoping to do more of these tutorial videos soon. This is one of the first ones, so I hope you guys like it. Probably won't have any more for Ezio just because it's done now, and this was the only one I thought of doing. It's going to take a while to do. Alright, so first thing is you start out with a strip of fabric that matches whatever fabric you're using for the doublet. Then you want to get 5/8 velvet ribbon to match the velvet that's in. I know for some of the designs sometimes it's green, sometimes it's black, it just depends. For the traditional it's usually red. Then here what I did is I used a ruler and cut about 1/4 inch on each side of the velvet ribbon. It doesn't really need to be exact. You just want it to be 1/4 inch or a little bit bigger, not a 1/2 inch. So anywhere in between that on each side of the velvet ribbon. So you have a strip that goes underneath it that is bigger than it for the next step. So you can see here just laying it out and roll cutting it with a, if you use a ruler, you know, that you can put on top of it, it's going to be a lot easier to get that straight line. That will be easier later on. I did also want to mention that you want a fabric that frays, but also is not going to, like, completely come apart, the main fabric for the doublet. This is because when you're doing stuff later, this will be very important. Alright, so now you're going to lay it out on top of the strip you made, your velvet ribbon, with the velvet side down. So you have the wrong side of the ribbon facing up. Then you're going to sew right on the edge of that ribbon, just right on the edge. You want to make it pretty straight, keeping that 1/4 inch or whatever amount you wanted out, even on both sides, and sew down the length of the ribbon. You might want to use a velvet foot. Here's it sewed finished. I apologize. I actually accidentally skipped recording a step. I have no idea why. Basically, I'm showing after you stitch on both sides, you turn it around and you actually cut down the middle. And then you flip it over and you start fraying the pieces on either side. So, which means you're pulling the threads to help it fray like that. And then to make it not look so uniform and nice, because honestly with a lot of cosplaying it looks nicer if you kind of distress things a little bit as you go, kind of like cut it unevenly just a little bit. You don't want to just cut big chunks out of it, but just make it look a little messier. Sometimes messier is actually good. It just depends where you apply it, and you just have to be careful with where you make it messy, otherwise it could just look messy. But all right so now basically this next step, pins are your friend. You're going to flip it back over how you had it when you were fraying it, and you're going to make sure that the extra pieces of fabric are underneath your ribbon, that they're not folding out. You can encourage this by ironing on the wrong side of the ribbon. You just want to make sure you don't iron directly on the velvet, because it can melt or it can squish the nap of the velvet. It makes it less velvety and nice. So you want to measure out where you want this to be on your doublet. And then I actually marked it with a blue pen that disappears with water. I don't know if you can see the markings. And then you're going to just use a ton of pins. Pins will be your friend. The velvet's going to want to wiggle a lot. And here just showing another piece of how you're flipping it over like that. All right. And then just go for it sewing. You probably want to remove the pins. I didn't. It's a bad habit I have, because if you don't remove the pins while you're sewing, sometimes you can break a needle and it sucks. In this step, go slow. Don't worry about taking your time. You don't want the fabric and the trim to like stretch from each other. Otherwise, it's going to create a lot of like ruffled, wrinkling looks. That's not going to be pretty later. So take your time with this step. You're going to have to repeat it a bunch of times, so you'll get used to it as you go. And don't be afraid to tear things out. That's how cosplay is. If something goes wrong, you can tear it out. And making this kind of trim doesn't take that long, so if something goes wrong or it looks uneven, just take it out and try again. Make sure you backstitch, secure all your edges. Here's it on the first piece. It's not ironed yet. Again, whenever you iron your velvet ribbon, you're not going to want to iron on the right side, otherwise you're going to squish that pretty velvet or melt it. That can happen too. and again, the finished product. So I hope you guys enjoyed, and good luck with your Ezio cosplay.